نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah talked about one surah in the Quran and he said if this is the only surah that was revealed out of the Quran that would be enough for this ummah. This surah talks about the real meaning of loss and the real meaning of success. It's a very short surah. It's only three verses, three ayat. And it starts by an oath by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This surah is called Surat Al-Asr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts the surah with an oath by saying, Wal-Asr. What's Al-Asr? Allah is saying, by time. So Allah is taking an oath by time. So according to some scholars, they said time here means ages. All the ages that went by. And we'll have to tie this to the next ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ Indeed, man, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word al-insan and not an-nas. Meaning, Allah is referring to each and every individual of us. So when you hear this, you think about yourself. Because normally, if Allah says, إِنَّ النَّاسَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ Indeed, mankind or all people, you also might blame it on others. He say, you know, everybody else is in loss, but not me. But Allah is saying, no, innal insan. Each individual, when you hear this, you should think about yourself because you're included. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wal asr, by time, some scholars of tafsir said, time here means all ages that went by. What does that mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed 1/3 of the Quran is history. What happened to the nations before us? Normally, mankind, sometimes they miss the purpose of their life. Why am I here? So people get so busy in what? In accumulating wealth, and then if someone else has more than me, I need to compete with him in this dunya. I need to get to his level. Why would he have more than me? So people across history, they were living their life to make money, to have power and authority. And Allah is telling us in all of these stories what happened to them at the end. All the first nations, look at the Pharaoh, for example. He was so powerful. And he used to boast in front of people. And he's the only one who transgressed all the limits of Allah. And he claimed to be Allah himself. مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِ That's what he said. When he got the power, he started boasting. He said, I don't know any God for you except me. Not only that, he claimed to be Al-Malik. أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرَ وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحتي. Am I not the king of Egypt? And these rivers, you know, flow beneath me. Not only that, he also not only claimed that he's God and he's al-Malik, he claimed to be the Rabb. أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. I am your Rabb, Master, Lord, the Most High. That's an example of what? Of insan. When they get power, and they get authority, and they get wealth. So Allah used time as a witness. Many people came before you in time, and they missed the purpose of their life, and they ended up in great loss. This is why the next ayat says, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. إِنَّ is confirmation, indeed. Al-insan, as I said, each and every individual amongst the human beings. La fi khusr. The lam again is another confirmation, for sure. So not only certainly or indeed, again Allah is using another confirmation. That he said fi khusr. Allah could have said inna al-insana la khasir. Or لَقَدْ خَسْرَ الْإِنسَانِ. Man has indeed lost. Or indeed man is a loser. But Allah said لَفِي خُسْر. And fi in the Arabic language to feed al-istighraq. Meaning, he's surrounded by loss from everywhere. He's drowning in loss. That's the meaning of لَفِي خُسْر. Allah uses the word خُسْر in the Quran, the word خَسَار, and the word khusran. What's the difference between the three? Khusr is the generic word, loss, whether it's like, you know, a minimum loss or a tremendous loss. Khasar means when that loss is increasing and doubles. As Allah said in Surat Nuh, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَنْ لَمْ يَزِدْهُ مَالُهُ وَوَلَدُهُ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And they followed none except those whose accumulation of wealth and boasting in numbers when it comes to children, except more and more loss. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Hajj, Surah number 22, ayah number 11, Allah said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ. Some people worship Allah, they enslave themselves to Allah, and Allah used the word harf as if they are on the cliff of a mountain, on the verge of something. فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اِطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ. If this dunya is good for him, if everything is going well, if he gets good, then he feels happy. He feels like I'm safe. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ. But when he is exposed to a trial or a test, انقلب على وجهه. He turned on his face. خسر الدنيا والآخرة. He would be a loser not only of this life, dunya, but the next life. Allah said, ذلك هو الخسران المبين. This is indeed the ultimate loss when you lose this dunya and you lose the akhirah, the hereafter too. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Wal-Asr. Some scholars said also, Al-Asr here means the time in the day, which is called Al-Asr, the afternoon. Why? Because this is the last salah during the daylight. And it gives you a sense of urgency, which means your day is coming to an end. Because with the sunset, the day is over. It means your life is coming to an end. Be careful. Use every single second of your time because it's too late. That's also another meaning of Al-Asr. Where Allah specifically chose the word Al-Asr here. A sense of urgency. Your time is about to end. Your day is about to end. Your life is about to end. Maximize the benefit of every single second of your time.
or it could mean just time. Because what's your capital? What's the most valuable thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you? It's your life. If I break down your life and my life, I'll break it down to what? A number of years. Break it down. A number of months. A number of weeks. A number of days. A number of hours. A number of minutes. A number of seconds. إِذَا ذَهَبَ يَوْمُكَ ذَهَبَ بَعْضُ عُمْرِكَ. When your day is over, some of your life is gone. And you can't bring it back. And it's too late to regret. Do you know that the people of Jannah will regret? Sheikh, are you mistaken? Do you mean the people of Hellfire? No. The people of Jannah will regret. What's their regret? That 1 hour of their life went by without benefiting by that, by doing الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّلْحَةِ. It's coming next. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, indeed, all of you as individuals amongst the human being are surely drowning in loss. That to me is exactly like, you know, when you go to school and it's the end of the year and you attended your exam and you're waiting for the results. And the principal of the school comes out and he said, no one succeeded. How would you feel? No one succeeded. Everybody will be crying. Imagine the day of judgment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announces that no one succeeded. How would you feel? The day ended and you didn't benefit by that day. You can't bring it back. So your day is gone. Your life is gone. How would you feel? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us hope. He said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. You know what? There is exception. Not all of you will be surrounded or drowning in loss. You know what? There is one way to succeed. And I'm going to give you the recipe of success. Four qualities. If you have them, you will be amongst the successful. You're not going to be in loss. And normally, learn this in the Arabic language, al-mustathna daiman 'adadun qaleel. When Allah makes an exception of a group, though that exception is always the few number. Because if the principal comes out and says, no one succeeded, and then he said, except 3 students out of 100. So the exception is always expected to be the small number. Because if the majority succeeded, the principal will not say nobody succeeded or all people failed. He would have said, you know, 90 people passed or succeeded, right? Except for 10. And that's exactly what Allah is saying. He said, the majority of people in this dunya will be losers. How? Why would you say this? Because that's what the Prophet ﷺ told us. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to call Adam on the day of judgment, the father of all humans, the father of humanity. He would say, Ya Adam, قم فأخرج بعث الجنة. He's going to say, stand up, Adam, and pick those who will go to Jannah. Then he would say, he will pick one out of each 1,000. Just think about this. 1,000, 999 of them are going to Hellfire, and one is going to Jannah. Would you like to be amongst those? Listen carefully to the rest of the surah. This is why this surah summarizes the entire Quran. In one statement, just 3 ayahs. By time is running, and everybody surrounded by loss from everywhere, we are immersing, we are drowning in loss, except those who have iman. We're going to stop at that. Then, they only have iman? No. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا except those who have iman and they do righteous deeds. Because many of us have iman, but when it comes to action, sometimes we are very conscious, we are very energetic, but then we slow down and slow down and then we forget. This is why Allah said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانِ. Big difference between al-insan and al-nas. I told you al-nas is the collective sense of the word. But al-insan, not only it's the individual, each one of us, but also from a linguistic point of view, the word al-insan stems from nisyan. Al-insan, asluha min al-nisyan. One of the meanings is that we as humans, we always forget. And we need reminders. And this is why it's a blessing that we forget. Because if we don't forget our pains, if we don't forget our hardships, we'll never be able to continue in this life. But you don't forget the purpose of your life. Because this is leading to loss. And this is the ultimate loss. So you need reminders. This is why Allah called the Quran, one of the names of the Quran, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرِ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ In Surah Al-Hijr, Surah number 15, and number 9, Allah says, indeed, we send down, and instead of saying the Quran, He sent the reminder. Because when you read the Quran, you read Surah Al-Asr, it will remind you. So what are the reasons of the loss? Subhanallah. Go back to the Surah before Surah Al-Asr, and the Surah right after Surah Al-Asr. Surah Al-Asr came in between. Surah Al-Takathur before it and Surah Al-Humaza after it. And these surahs are telling you the reasons of why people, you know, get trapped into that loss. In Surah Al-Takathur, Allah said, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Al-haakum al-takathur, you have been distracted by asking for more and more and more. You have more than enough to lead a good, decent life. But you start competing with other people. So be aware of takathur. Be happy with what you want. It's enough for you, alhamdulillah. But when you compete with people about the dunya, this is one distraction that will lead you to loss. So you get busy with the dunya and all what you care about is money, children, authority, houses, cars. These are all means and you get distracted and all of a sudden you leave all of this and you go to the grave. حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ doesn't literally here mean you visit the graves. No, you go to the graves. Then what do you take with you when you go to the grave? وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ The way for salvation, the way to success is be careful. Take care of what you will take with you in the grave. You will take nothing but your good deeds. But you're so busy in this dunya, having more money, having more authority, having more houses, more cars. SubhanAllah. This is one reason. This is why Allah, you know, reveal Surah Al-Asr in the middle between Surah Al-Takathur. Don't be distracted by asking for more and more of this dunya. Focus on what will benefit you in the Akhirah. And the next surah said, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ وَيْلٌ وَادٍ فِي جَهَنَّمْ تَسْتَغِيثُ مِنْهُ جَهَنَّمْ مِنْ شِدَّةْ مَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ According to Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه. وَيْلٌ is a certain spot in hellfire, and hellfire itself seeks refuge with Allah from the severe punishment in that spot. So Allah is saying that spot is waiting for who? لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ For everyone, once they, you know, pile and they accumulate and they have lots of money and lots of wealth, they start boasting and they start belittling others. Look at the car he's driving. Look at the car I'm driving. Look at the neighborhood where he lives. Look at my house. I'm living in a mansion. He's living in a tent. He's living in a one-bedroom. So you start belittling people and making fun of them. Why? الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدًا. Because what makes him feel above everyone else, and he belittles others and he makes fun of them, because he has gathered lots of money and he keeps checking his account. How much is there today? What's the balance? And he's adding more. What's in the balance today? And what does he think? يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. He thinks that his money, his wealth, will make him immortal in this life. He will live forever. كَلَّا. Allah said, no. لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ. He will be thrown in a fire that will destroy him and destroy his arrogance, as he destroyed people by belittling them and making fun of them. So, how can I be saved? That's the continuation of the surah. Allah said, if you want to be saved, listen carefully. There are four qualities. You have to have these four qualities. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Except those who have iman. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And they do righteous deeds. Not only that. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. And they always remind each other of following the truth. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. If you follow the truth, what will happen? People will not like you. Because people, they will say, you know, everybody's doing this, man. Everybody's dealing with riba. They're making lots of money. Everybody's like lying or cheating or this or that. I am a human being too. Why don't I follow them? No, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَا يَكُنْ أَحَدُكُمْ إِمَّعَ. Don't be a yes man. إِذَا أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ أَحْسَنُوا وَإِنْ أَسَاءُوا فَأَسَاءُوا. If they do good, you do good. And if they do bad, you do bad. ولكن وطروا أنفسكم فإذا أحسن الناس فأحسنوا وإن أساءوا فتجنبوا إساءتهم. But be a good Muslim with your own good character. If people do good, do good. If they do bad, stay away from the bad that they are doing. That's Iman. You stick to your faith. You believe in Allah. You believe in the angels. That they are writing down everything. Allah didn't say, Allah could have used the individual again. You see, when Allah talked about lust, He said al-insan, right? But here He didn't say, إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ الصَّالِحَاتِ وَأَوْصَى غَيْرَهُ بِالْحَقِّ وَأَوْصَى غَيْرَهُ بِالصَّبْرِ. Allah used the collective now. He said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ, except those. Why? Now when it comes to Iman, you need to be in an environment full of Iman. So you need to be with your Muslim brothers. You need to be in an environment that will remind you of Allah. Don't stay away from your ummah. Be together. And subhanAllah, the greatest lesson to be learned from this, we all know the story of the man who killed 100 people when he wanted to make tawbah and he went to the scholar. Not the ignorant one who was like a monk. He doesn't have knowledge. When he went to the scholar, what did the scholar say to him? He said, اترك قومك فإنهم قوم سوء. And that's what we're always afraid of from. He said, leave your society, leave your community, because it's a bad one. Leave your group of friends, because they are bad ones. Because if you continue with the bad friends, what's going to happen? As if you are in a swamp full of, you know, filth and dirt, and you're trying to clean yourself. So that itrug is heavy for us, is difficult for us. Like, leave what's wrong, leave what's bad. And then he said, وَانْطَلِقْ إِلَىٰ أَرْضِ كَذَا. So when you substitute, when you want to replace that bad company, that bad friends, replace them with good friends. So he said, go to the other land. فَإِنَّ فِيهَا أُنَاسًا يَعْبُدُونَ اللَّهِ. Because there are good people. Those are الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Because they will help you to do righteous deeds. فَاعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَعَهُمْ. Then worship Allah and enslave yourself to Allah with them. So be with the people of Iman. Because they will help you to do righteous deeds. And guess what? That man succeeded. Why? Because he remembered Al-Asr. He did not procrastinate. He did not say, you know what, tomorrow inshallah, next week. No. He said, فانطلق. And then he passed away. Like one narration said, he just swerved like this. And then he died. Another narration said, he started walking right away towards the land of repentance, of good people. And then when the angels of mercy and the angels of punishment, they were arguing. No, the angels of punishment, they said, he should go to hellfire. He didn't do anything good in his life and he killed 100 people. And the other one said, no, لَقَدْ جَاءَ مُنِيبًا بِقَلْبِهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. He came without procrastination right away with a sincere heart, turning back in repentance to Allah. Urgency. Now, Al-Asr, time is running. You can't control it. They even said Al-Asr comes from the verb Ya'asr. When you squeeze something, it means you get to have it to get the what's remaining in it. As if like, you know, Al-Asr, the time of Asr, there is only a small part of your days remaining. So squeeze that time and maximize the benefit from every second. So that man did not waste 1 second. This is why, subhanAllah, when they measure the land, the distance between the land of obedience and the land of disobedience, he was going to the land of righteous people, they found him closer by one span, that much, to the land of obedience. So the angels of mercy take him to Jannah. Why did this man succeed? Because he followed Al-Asr. I'm not going to waste time. Imagine if he waited 1 second, he wouldn't have made that difference. Al-Asr, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So it's Iman. And then, I just want to share a hadith with you, because the Prophet ﷺ said, نِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ الصَّحَّةِ وَالْفَرَاغِ. Two blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet ﷺ said, many people amongst us are maghboon. And I'm going to stop at the word maghboon to explain it to you. Ghabn means, if I'll give you an example. If you have a car that's worth $100,000, and then you sell that car for $1,000, that's called ghabn. If you sell it for $1,000, you export yourself to ghabn. Meaning, that's a great loss. Because it's worth 100,000. How come you sell it for 1,000? Allah has given you 70 years. Allah has given you 50 years. This is your capital. Wal-Asr. Your time is running. Your life is going to an end. Maximize the benefit. Why would you lose it in doing nothing good? Why would you lose it in doing something bad? That's the meaning of ghabn. So many of us, they will spend 3 hours, 4 hours, and they don't even remember, like, what did they do in those 4 hours? Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak was asked a question. He said, if I am coming and the imam is in sujood, it means I already lost the rak'ah. Should I make sujood with him or wait for him to stand up for the following rak'ah? He said, go, make sujood, you never know. This could be the difference. That could be the sajda that Allah will accept from you and it will take you to Jannah. This could be even the last sajda. If you wait until he stands up, you might die. Wal-Asr, time is running. Maximize the benefit. Don't waste 1 second if it's something good that you will do. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. One day, one of the professors at the university, he wanted to explain to the other students why this student was always the top student. She asked him to stand up, and he said, I have some questions for you. What are you going to do on Monday in the afternoon? He said, I have this and this schedule. He said, what about Tuesday after Maghrib? He said, I have this and this schedule. He said, what about Friday, you know, after Jummah? He said, I have this and this schedule. So he turned to the other students. He said, his schedule is busy. He's maximizing his time to do something good. You know, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, this life, this time that Allah has given us in this life is like a journey. And once one of us is born, the arrow of death is shot. And your life is that distance between you walking to meet that arrow of death. So that journey, which is your time, Al-Asr, that Allah has given you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you like a bird with a head and two wings. The head is the love of Allah. If you love Allah, you'll be happy during that journey regardless of what happens to you. Because you know some people, they forget the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. We have created man in toil, difficulty, hardship. You will go through this. Don't ever think of this life that you will have anything ultimate. No ultimate happiness, no ultimate health. Take it the way it is. Then you will have the peace of the heart and the peace of the mind. And this is why many people today are depressed and stressed, because they don't accept the Qadr of Allah. So if you accept this, you will move in this life with the love of Allah. Ya Allah, I'm happy with anything that come across my life. And the two wings in your journey back to Allah with that head of love is hope is one wing and fear is the other wing. When you are away from Allah, you have to increase that wing of hope, because Allah will always forgive you as long as you go back to Him and do tawbah. And when you are close to Allah, don't think high of yourself. I don't need anybody to remind me of the haq. I don't need anybody to remind me of patience because I'm a very good man. No. You need to raise that wing of fear, because Allah could change your heart in less than a second. This is why the most common dua of the Prophet ﷺ was, Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub. ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِي عَلَى دِينِكَ. O Allah, the one who turns the heart between one second and the other, make my heart firm on Iman, on believing in you. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I wish I had more time to continue Surah Al-Asr, because really it's a way of life, it's an entire way of life for all of us. But I'll just summarize the last meaning, and inshallah hopefully in other khutbas we can elaborate more. Allah said, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. So you have to maximize every single second of your time, Al-Asr, because time is running and you can't bring it back. And stay away from being distracted. The lesson in Surat At-Takathur, by accumulating, you know, more and more of this dunya, forgetting that you're going to go to the grave and you'll take nothing except your good deeds. So remember, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those who have Iman and do righteous deeds. And don't also be amongst those in the following surah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. Allah is, you know, promising those who belittle others, who make fun of others because they are below them, maybe socially or financially. Allah said, no, don't think that your money or your status will save you. It's the good deeds that you will do in this life. Be humble and be down to earth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said at the end, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. As I said, as individuals, I might forget, I need a reminder. As an individual, you might forget, you need a reminder. So Allah said, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. And tawasaw comes, you know, one word that stems from tawasaw is wasiyah. Before you die, you have to write your wasiyah. If somebody is on the verge of death and they have not written their wasiyah, they bring everyone and they say, come, please, quickly, there is urgency, I'm dying. I want you to listen to me, this is my wasiyah to you. This is my advice before I leave this life to you. This is how urgent it is that we all need to remind each other of the truth. And also another wasiyah, sense of urgency, you know, that wherever we go through, when we follow the truth, you will be attacked by others. People will not like you because there is no comfort in the truth. People like you to say, you know, you're the best one, even though you're not, because the Prophet, you know, sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us the importance of a friend. And a true friend, صديقك من صدقك لا من صدقك. Your true friend is the one who will give you advice, and he will be honest in giving you that advice from a sincere heart, not somebody who will always say, you are the best. Because there is nobody who is the best. All of us have flaws and shortcomings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who listen to the speech and follow the best of it. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم لا تدع لنا وللحاضرين ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا غائبا إلا رددته، ولا ضالا إلا هديته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضا ولنا صلاحا إلا يسرتها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث، فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين، واغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين، واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وآخر الصلاة.